Hey everyone, Scorch82 here. Welcome to Let's Play Bionic Commando Rearmed for the PC. And watch this little intro real quick here. So, I don't know if many of you know, but I actually did a review and walkthrough of Bionic Commando Rearmed. I don't know how many months ago it was. Probably back in August or September last year for the Xbox 360. And I'm actually going to run through this one on the PC this time because I actually think the graphics are a little better and I wanted to redo the game with commentary in HD. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Let's go ahead and start a new game here. We're going to start single player. Yes, we can erase old progress. We're going to play on medium. Captain, do you read me? Here are your mission objectives. Your first priority is to find and rescue Super Joe. We don't know where the Imperials are keeping him captive, so you'll have to intercept their communications and track down his whereabouts. Your secondary objective is to slow down the Imperial advance by causing any disruption you can at their installations. Your pilot, Haley, will transport you and keep track of your mission progress in the mission log. Now, proceed into the war zone. Tread carefully and make us proud, son. Over and out. Come on board, Captain. I'm Haley. I'll be your pilot for this mission. I'll keep a comm line open at all times, just to give me a holler if you're in trouble, and I'll get you to safety. Good to hear, Haley. So, who did you make mad to end up with this duty? Ha! Don't let my looks fool you, Captain. This gal has more stones than any other pilot in the force. Good. Well, let's get this mission in the air. Yes, sir. There's a tutorial in Area Zero. Just let me know if you want to land there or if you want to proceed straight into the battle zone. Okay, so I don't know how many of you are familiar with the first Bionic Commando for the NES, but the map screen is top-down view, and you're given the ability to fly to different areas, both combat zones and neutral zones. So the red numbered squares with white letters are the neutral zones, and then the white squares with red numbers are the combat zones. We're going to start by landing in Zone Zero. So Bionic Commando Rearmed works, well, Bionic Commando in general works differently in that you have... I left the zone. You have a bionic arm instead of being able to jump, and you're going to use this thing to maneuver yourself around. So, completing jumping, swinging, saving yourself from falling in a pit. That arm is going to be your best friend, so you'll probably want to get used to the physics. You can fire your weapon. In the NES version, you couldn't fire it in neutral zones or you would sound an alarm, but in this one, you can fire at will, and it doesn't matter. These are simulator rooms, where upon entering them, you can do tutorials. I'm going to skip them for now. But you'll be able to go through certain situations and scenarios in a simulated environment where you won't actually lose any health or lives doing so. In this first area, most people don't think to go here because in the actual NES version you couldn't go here. They don't think to come in here and find the weapon upgrade for the revolver, which lets you fire faster and have more bullets on screen at the same time. So, if you do yourself a favor and come here first, you can get that. I'm going to attempt to show you where to get all of the hidden items throughout the playthrough. Some of them are a little more tricky than others, but we're going to go ahead and try to do that. I'm going to stop at Area 13 first. I think there's a comms chip that we're going to want to get here. You can talk to people by pressing up when they have the speech bubble. Hey, you're that special op that's in behind enemy lines, aren't you? What did they call you? The Bionic Commando. I hope your results are better than that name. Gee, thanks. Captain, through this door is the challenge simulation room. There you can practice your skills without having to worry about getting hurt. It's all simulated. So these challenge rooms are kind of an extra little feature where they put you in a simulated environment. And, let's do the first one. You basically have an objective to complete within the time limit. Some of them are much harder than this, but this is kind of, you know, just at a first level thing. So, nowhere near the fastest time you can even get, but that's kind of what those are all about. So if you find yourself needing an extra little challenge, there's, I think, 56 of them. So they'll give you plenty of run for your money. I don't even know why these Imperials are attacking. How can they possibly think that... How can they possibly think they can beat the might of the FSA military? Moron. Reading is a little off today. I won't talk to everybody, because not everybody says anything useful. Grab the flares here. We're going to need that in another area. You always want to make the effort to stop at these neutral areas whenever you can, because the items that you can find there are useful. With those flares, the pitch black darkness in Area 4 won't be a problem anymore. The place will be lit up like an amusement park. And usually after you find something specific, Haley will chime in and tell you what it's for. But let's go to the first area here, the oil refinery. This is a pretty good area to get used to the game physics. So you can grab these barrels here. We can toss them at enemies. And they'll drop these blue hexagon shapes, which we can use to up our score. Most of the enemies here are going to be a little stupid when it comes to firing at you. They're going to stay, most of them won't duck down, but if they do, you can take them out faster than they can hit you. You want to make your way up to the top here to get into the first comm room. Most of the levels you're required to go to the comm room and contact HQ before you can proceed. Let's do that. Captain Spencer, it's such an honor to work with you. I'm Agent MA1. The pleasure's all mine. So what have you got for me? First things first, there are communication rooms like this in every Imperial base. You should try to access them all. They might hold valuable information, and once you've established contact with us from a base, we can upload access codes to your arm. That way you can open doors that were previously locked. Sounds good. Also, I managed to disable the network security in this facility. The alarm won't go off now, even if you fail when you try to hack their network. You should use this opportunity to hone your hacking skills. This might be your only chance to do so without the risk of sounding the alarm. I'll give it a shot. Good job, Agent. My pleasure. Underneath your current location, there's a cave. The entrance is close by, and I've uploaded the access code to your arm. So doors are unlocked after I've acquired the access codes. Got it. Yep. Try to contact HQ frequently, at least when you enter a new area. Well, I look forward to working with you, Captain. MA1 out. Okay, so your other option would be to hack the enemy network, and it'll present you with this little mini-game, where you're given a grid, and you have to maneuver the yellow ball to the green square by rotating the grid and dropping it. So we can continue to do that. So basically just rotating the screen until you're able to drop it down on the green cube. And you can learn things about how to defeat the enemies in each level. Sir, here's the status report you requested on the D-1 Beetle. Apparently, it has only one shield plate protecting either the top or the bottom of the hull. Regardless, I think it's safe to say the D-1 Beetle is pretty much impregnable. Why is that, Private? Well, the flight control system can't be damaged by ordinary gunfire. Only a severely violent impact could do any damage. That's reassuring. Alright, so that'll kind of give us a little hint. And every time you do that, it'll drop out health and point tokens from that little vacuum chute right there. Do these guys in, man. Right, swing over to the other side here. This guy's gonna hide. Come on out. Toss the barrel at this guy over here. Okay. Climb up top. If you grab up to the corner here, you can take this guy out. barrels can usually deflect fire. Okay, so I'm going to attempt to show you where the first hidden Yasichi is. It's a secret in this level. If you get up to this level, this ledge here, and then drop off and try to grab at the corner, the furthest over you can, and leap out, and then do a sideways grapple, and then just keep grappling as you progress and grab that ledge. It'll be up here when you do that. So you can attempt to try to grapple back. I'm probably going to end up losing a life doing it, but if you don't want to do that, you can always call for an extraction. Yeah, it's harder to do that. The reason we didn't see the Yasichi over there is because I picked it up in a previous game.